Thanks for joining us here online. I'm Adam Sexton with a look at some of the stories we're following this afternoon. A Concord man accused of stabbing a woman to death is facing a judge on an unrelated charge. Deshaun Jetty appeared in circuit court by video before heading to Superior Court to face murder charges. Prosecutors say on April 7th, Jetty left the scene of a car crash on Maple Street in Concord. According to court paperwork, Jetty then lied to police when questioned about what happened, saying he did not know about the accident. For this incident, Jetty faces a Class A misdemeanor charge. Jetty's also facing the two counts of second-degree murder. The Attorney General's office says he is responsible for the death of 23-year-old Sabrina Galusha. Galusha was stabbed in the chest Thursday night outside of the Pennacook apartment complex. A dairy man convicted of providing a deadly dose of drugs is scheduled to be sentenced today. 28-year-old Jesse Carrillo was found guilty of involuntary manslaughter in the 2013 death of 20-year-old Eric Sinicori. Authorities say Carrillo provided heroin to Sinicori that led to an overdose death. At the time, Sinicori was working as an informant for UMass campus police. He agreed to be an informant in exchange for authorities to not pursue charges in a drug investigation he was facing. Right now, Manchester police are trying to track down the man seen in this photo. Police say he walked into the Irving gas station on Roundstone Avenue dressed in a mask, showed the clerk a black and silver handgun before taking off with cash. And in Concord right now, police are investigating their third robbery this week. The latest happened at the Dunkin' Donuts on Manchester Street yesterday afternoon. Authorities are looking into whether all three incidents are connected. At the State House this morning, lawmakers have voted to decriminalize 3/4 of an ounce of marijuana. The bill is now headed to the governor's desk and he's expected to sign it. It is getting down to crunch time in Concord. State senators worked late into the night debating the state budget last night. Republicans ended up passing the $11.8 billion plan. The approval came after the Senate rejected more than 24 attempts by Democrats to boost funding for mental health services, higher ed, DCYF, and a number of other programs. Today in the House, legislators already voted on and approved a fetal homicide law, and they're going to vote on a controversial bill aimed at tightening up voter registration. News 9 has learned that former Portsmouth mayor and Democratic candidate for governor Steve Marchand has hired the same consulting firm that handled Bernie Sanders' presidential campaign. Mr. Marchand lost the Democratic primary for governor in 2016, but says he's jumping into this race because Governor Chris Sununu has already started raising money for his own reelection. For more information, you can, of course, head to the primary source page of WMUR.com. Well, June is not too late for skiing. Tonight at 5, who opened their slopes today? And as more stores shut down for good, what will happen to America's shopping malls? That does it for us here on All Online. I'm Adam Sexton. Have a great afternoon.